So human papillomavirus is a viral infection. It is actually one of the more common sexually transmitted infections that we see. I mean, HPV infection per se is the most common infection. So if we were to sample people who have been sexually active at one point, it will outrank any other infection in terms of being the most common sexually transmitted infection. But only a portion of that infection will result in genital warts. Now, genital warts are like benign skin tumors. They often look like small mini cauliflower outgrowths at sites which have been exposed in the genital areas, which have been exposed to any form of sexual contact. So there are 100 types, there are more than 100 subtypes of HPV infection. And it's only generally two subtypes which cause genital warts, and they're the non-cancer producing types. So which is often confused, because there's some cancer producing types of HPV which cause cancer, but the HPV subtypes that cause genital warts are actually non-cancer producing. So genital warts is also something that we see very commonly within the HIV infected population. But once again, it's very, very treatable, either with topical creams such as podophyllin toxin ointment or Aldera, which contains imiquimod cream, or just a spray with liquid nitrogen, which they often require to come back at weekly intervals for a period of about 3 to 4 times. So treatable, a bit of a nuisance for those who have got infected. The problem also is that even after treatment, 60% of people may get it all over again. So very frustrating for patients who get it. And now there's a vaccine, which a very good vaccine, two types of HPV vaccines which prevent from getting HPV infection. But only one of the vaccine, Gardasil vaccine, prevents from getting genital warts. If we're really going through the sexual history of patients, maybe very few patients will then get vaccinated because they would feel that they're not at risk. A patient who may have one sexual partner, I mean, you may have one sexual partner, but ultimately the reality of it is you may not know whether your sexual partner that is having sex with anybody else. So rather than think in the terms of I only have one sexual partner and therefore I'm not at risk, why don't we just consider vaccinating ourselves and preventing an infection that in women causes cervical cancer, in men can cause other types of HPV related cancers such as anal cancer. Now, HPV infection is now also gaining a lot of popularity in the research agenda across the world, because it's now being increasingly implicated in causing oral and throat cancers related to oral sex. I mean, Michael Douglas famously came on the media and announced that he had developed a type of oral cancer secondary to HPV. And that added a lot of publicity to HPV infection as a causation of cancer, which actually was very good of him to do that. So now there's a vaccine which prevents that, and it's highly recommended. It is a fairly expensive vaccine, but it does protect you from a cancer though, or certain types of cancer. So in my estimation of cost-benefit analysis, it certainly rises in terms of the benefit that it confers. Any form of a sexually transmitted infections, in particular ulcerative, so any infections result in loss of lining, will result in an increased risk of HIV acquisition or getting HIV. But the other way around, now, HIV infection per se increases the risk of HPV. So that's true, I guess, because in HIV infection, your immunity is reduced. And therefore you're at risk of acquiring infections. But part of that is also maybe explained by sexual behavior, you know? So it's not just immunity per se, but also sexual behavior. What people forget also is that smoking increases your risk of HPV acquisition. And it's certainly one modifiable risk factor that a lot of people can do in terms of maybe giving up smoking to reduce their overall risk, not so much of HPV infection, but the risk of HPV infection allowing the cells to progress to cancerous stages. So smoking is very much like reduces also your immune system somewhere, and that's how it plays a part in causation of cancer, not just lung cancer, but HPV-related cancers.